Hey guys, welcome back to Auto Repair Guys. Thank you guys for watching and subscribing to the channel. In today's video guys, here we'll be working on a Dodge Journey guys, generation 2009 to 2019, and we're going to show you guys how to remove and how to replace ignition coils. We'll have more than 200 videos on Dodge Journey guys, so please subscribe to the channel. Our mission at the shop is to save you as much money as we can by teaching you how to fix your car for free. All we need in return, subscribe and a like, guys. Now, this is a 3.6 engine, but if you have a different engine, most of the videos will apply to your car as well. Just the engine videos will be different. But we're planning on getting the other engine as well. Now, if you have the 3.6, most likely you have the cover here, the engine cover. Ours is missing the cover. Usually what you have to do in order to remove it, sometimes you have to remove the oil cap, and you just pull it straight up. It has four places where it attaches, you can see here, here, and then you have one more and one right there. So on those round things, rubber bushings go in, so we have to do just grab it and pull it up. After that, we have to do the remove upper intake, intake boot there, all that stuff, so we can get to the ignition coils, guys. Quite a bit of work, stay with us and we'll start on it. Alright guys, all the parts and tools including the ignition coils will be listed in the description of the video below. So we try to make it a little bit more convenient for you if you're trying to find parts and tools. So next we just need to get a flathead screwdriver, get that clamp loose now. Okay, let's see if we can get that boot out. Yep, perfect. And then there is one more clamp right there. Okay, we're getting this one out now. So now we just grab it and we gently need to pull that thing out. Careful not to break any vacuum hoses in the way or anything like that. Okay, you can see, came like that. So now we have one rubber guide. A glide right here. This one in our case looks like it's broken. You have two more on the back side. Okay, they're like, you'll feel them, one right here, one over there. And what you need to do, okay, you need to pull straight up to come out of the rubber bushings. And after that, okay, this sensor here for the temperature, intake temperature sensor, pull that one out. And when it's out of the other two sensors, okay, all we have to do now, just start pulling it out. Okay, and now we just need to mess with it, okay, until we get it out. I think it will come out only one way, because there is one, one thing holding on the bottom. So let me figure out, okay, which way this thing will come out. Show you what is the easiest way to remove it. So what we'll do, we'll actually remove that little hose, it's in the way. Okay, so let me get this one out of here now. If the engine is hot, never do that because it's part of the cooling system. Okay, you don't want to burn yourself because it could be under enormous amount of pressure. So, okay, it got loose now. You might be able to do it without removing the hose. Okay, but I wouldn't recommend it. Now, right here, there is one clamp on the backside, one plastic retainer that we need to pop up. That way the hose will go down. Okay, like that, and now I think, let's see if we'll be able to pull that guy out of here. Oh, maybe it still will not work, guys. Okay, this thing is ridiculous, I'm telling you. So, I don't know if it will come out without removing the intake manifold, the upper intake. because there is two guys holding on the back. So if you push towards the back, okay, come out like that. I think we almost got it out. Okay, like that. Those are the two, okay, there was a little bit of water. There are two bushings on the back that we need to release in order to pull that thing out. Let me show you where they are on the engine quick. Okay, if you look towards the back side, this is one of them. This is the other one right there. So next, you can remove the whole upper intake together with the, I believe with the throttle body. We will inspect here in a second, but we will take them apart because we want to make a video, guys, how to replace throttle body, how to clean it as well. We want to clean ours because those are known to give engine light on, engine coats, and a little bit of unstable idling. So we'll be cleaning ours. Check out the video. So with 8mm socket now. Okay, there are four screws that we need to remove. Here we will have to do it by hand. We will not be able to do the impact because it's a little bit of limited room. And it's a good thing we decided to remove the throttle body because check this thing out. We have electrical tape stuck inside somewhere. It sucked it through the intake, got there, and that's why the car was idling a little bit funny. So one more. So two left. Okay, this. And now we have one more on top holding, but let's remove this one. Perfect. Now we need to disconnect the wires here. Okay, this. You kind of slide it out. Now this wire right here, you can see that's a safety pin. You need to pull that thing, okay, out. Okay, like that. Press down now. Okay, that's perfect. And pull it out. And we got the throttle body out of the way now. This is where the electrical tape is stuck. So now, if you need to work on cylinder 1, 3 and 5, let's say, spark plugs or ignition coils, you don't need to take apart more things, but in our case, what we usually do, we just replace all the spark plugs or all the ignition coils, because sooner or later all of them will be bad. So if you're in the process of replacing one, I would recommend to do all of them. So now we'll need to continue disassembling here now. So now we need to get 8mm socket, and we'll need to start removing a few screws now for the upper intake. It's very important not to over tighten those later. It says 7 to 9 Newton meters. So we keep doing that now. We'll be fixing a common oil leak on that engine as well. We have so many videos, guys. If you have any specific problem, drop a comment below. We'll get the idea about fixing things, and also we'll try to make a video for your specific problem. Okay, those are loose now. With 10mm, we have to remove two nuts holding the intake right here. That's the upper intake. Okay, perfect. This one's been loose for like 2 seconds and we're still spinning it. Great. Okay, don't drop things like we do. Now we need to start disconnecting a few hoses. We need to also disconnect, okay, here the this will be the map sensor in a little bit. Okay, that map sensor right here. Okay, we need to pull that red thing to the back. Now press down on it and pull the wire out, but ours is stuck a little bit. Okay, perfect. Okay, with the clip removal too, we need to remove that holder there. Again, all the tools and parts, guys, that we use will be listed in the description of the video below the video, so please check it out for your convenience. This thing is almost done. We just want to make sure we don't break them, because if we do, we have to replace all that stuff later. Okay, perfect, like that. Now we have one vacuum hose right here that we'll need to pull out. This one, we might even do it in a little bit when I get to it. Okay, and in the meantime, we'll remove that hose there. Okay, this one, I got it loose, but it's moving now. Okay, it's coming out. Perfect, just careful not to break your intake. Now, we can go ahead, remove that bracket here, that clamp, and we need to pull that hose out now. This one will be stuck, most likely. Okay, like that. Here, we have one more nut holding. Two nuts. Okay, one on this side, one on the other side, with a 10 millimeter socket. So now it's still holding, guys. This bracket right here, we need to go ahead and remove those brackets so we can get it out. Quite a bit of disassembly here. So now we'll be removing that cable here. Okay, over the ball there is one plastic holder for the wires here, so we need to pull that one out. And this one, usually you want to get it a little bit on each side, okay, and then it will come out. If you just try to go on one side, okay, it's not going to come out. Okay, and you can see this one came out. Now we can use, let's see, a wrench, I think, that will actually let us take that bolt off. So we're on the left side of the engine now, where we remove the two nuts. So what we'll be doing now, we'll try to remove that nut and bolt and get that bracket out. And if that bracket comes out now, we won't have to mess with the ones on the front. So we want to see which one is easier, guys, so you don't have to do the same amount of work that we do. Probably save you a little bit of headache. Okay, this nut is almost out. Perfect. So what we did right here now, okay, we pull that bracket of the bolt here. Okay, you can see I pulled it out, and then I pulled it up like that. Now we're going to use a 13 millimeter deep socket to remove that bolt, and this bracket should come out, hopefully. Okay, so we have extension with a deep socket 13, and we're trying to remove that bolt now. Whoever thought of that design, guys, I think they wanted you to go to the dealership. because that's quite a bit of work. Okay, we need to just pull it out in a little bit. Perfect. It's right there. Now we'll just grab it. Pull the bolt out. Okay, this is what it looks like. Let me show you a little bit more. Okay, it goes this way on the bracket. Now we'll need to pull that bracket out like that. Okay, and we can just leave it there now. We have one more bolt right here with the 8mm that we need to remove. That's one that we didn't see at first. So we'll go ahead, remove that one now, and then we'll be ready to continue with the next step. Okay, let's see now if we can lift up on this side a little bit and get it out of here. Perfect. So you can see that saved us quite a bit of headache, guys. Now one of the gaskets, okay, is stuck here. The other ones are over there. You can see that's how they need to be, right here. So we're going to cover the intake now. Make sure that you cover your hole so you don't drop anything. Even I would recommend to put a bigger towel or something, because if you drop something in the valves and you don't notice it, your engine will be done. Okay, now we can pull that piece. It's extremely dirty and dusty usually, so pull that thing out and we can proceed with the next step. Okay guys, now with the intake, upper intake out of the way, you can see we can reach the ignition coils for all cylinders. You can see 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. You have on the rear side 1, 3, 5, you have 2, 4, 6 on this side. Now, as you can see guys, we'll just demonstrate now on one ignition coils because there is no need to waste your time watching all 6. You'll see where we get our replacement one. Link will be listed in the description of the video below for your convenience, guys. Check it out. Now, we need to go ahead. Let's disconnect the cable first. Okay, let's disconnect one cable. We'll do, okay, ignition coil number 4. Okay, let's do ignition coil number 4. So right here, you need to press down. Okay, and when you press down on that thing, you need to pull out. But sometimes they will be stuck. Now I wouldn't recommend to pull on the wires too much because you can damage them. Okay, like that. Now let's get a 10mm socket, remove the bolt. Okay, just needs a little bit more. And okay, it's loose now, but it's still going in the ignition coil. Perfect, this is the bolt. Now grab the ignition coil, okay, and just pull it out, okay, like that. We'll get the replacement one and show you how to install it now. So we'll get our new ignition coil now, and we're ready to install it. You just go in one specific way. You need to get the coil on, install the bolt now. So let me grab the bolt quick. Okay, right here. Can see shiny new coil, guys. Check out where we get them from, really good price. And later you need to connect your wire, and from that point on everything else will be, guys, pretty much in reverse order that we took everything apart. You need to install everything in reverse way. So thank you guys for watching. Please subscribe to the channel and see you guys next time.